Another thing that is a problem with Tomasulo's algorithm is when we try to do branch mispredictions. So how do we recover from a branch misprediction? So let's say we have a program like this, where we have a divide. It takes something like 40 cycles. And once we get that result, we can resolve this branch over here. So this branch can be predicted, but it can take a long time to realize that it's been mispredicted. So let's say, meanwhile, we have fetched this instruction because the branch should have been taken. We have fetched this instruction, and this instruction is already done. In that case, R3 is already written. Once we realize that we have mispredicted this branch, possibly 40, 50 cycles later, we should behave like we have never executed this instruction and instead start fetching instructions from the label that the branch is pointing to. But that becomes impossible because R3 by that time has already been updated. So instead of having the old value of R3, now we have the new value of R3 when we jump to the label. So again, the problem is very similar to precise exceptions in that pretty much an instruction can complete and write to registers before preceding instructions have fully been verified and before we even know that this instruction should have been executed. A final problem occurs because of so-called phantom exceptions. So what we can have is, let's say that there is a divide here. Let's say that we have mispredicted this branch. Let's say that this instruction doesn't execute too soon and so on. But the problem is, if there is a divide here and it generates an exception, the exception will be triggered even though this instruction was never supposed to be executed. So when we come back, we have now a problem of basically we have already started exception processing for this. We have, you know, done everything for this exception by the time we realize that it's too late. So again, we have to somehow take care of not having exceptions until we are sure that they should happen.